Welkom, Freek van Eyck is in de studio hier. He's the director of Holland Circular Hotspot. And you're very passionate about making business a driver to a new economy and a sustainable world. And how important are events like Ecomondo, what we were just watching, how important are they?
Well, I think Ecomondo is probably one of the most important green economy fairs in Europe. I think Raimondo mentioned 100,000 visitors. That's impressive. And it's especially, I think, the place to be for the Italians. So everybody who's relevant in the circular economy will be there. Politicians, representatives from business sectors, etc. And what's like about Ecomondo, what you saw, what is nice, is that the Dutch tried to match this Italian presence with a very relevant delegation. So we have a Netherlands lounge organized by the consulate, embassy, FME, and they tried to get representative companies there. So I remember seeing Arcadis, European Solar, MTT, Join the Pipe, Doppler, etc. And last year, I think there were 15 Dutch individual stands next to the NL lounge. So there's really a cachara. Something is happening there. That's fun. Unfortunately, this year, it's only digital, actually starting today till the 6th of November. But that doesn't mean it's not worth it, because there are really quite relevant sessions going on. State of the green economy, regulation and circular economy, and of course, circular economy and water. So next year, we have to be there.
Definitely live. But watching the video and hearing you speak also makes me realize that circular economy is a hot topic in Italy. How does Italy score in this sector?
Well, I'm actually very glad you asked, because I think Italy doesn't really get the credit it deserves. It's actually doing a lot better. It's one of the top performers in Europe, and of the five biggest countries in Europe, it's probably one of the best. And I think it comes because, like the Netherlands, they're poor in resources. They have lots of SMEs and family companies who have an intrinsic driver to think circular and to optimize things better. If you look at the statistics, it's surprising. In resource productivity, Italy is number one. They're the second industrial recycler. I think already 18.5% of all resources they use are actually also secondary. And it's not only resources, also in energy productivity. They're top three. I think 40% of electricity is also already renewable. So if you look at Italy, actually, what you see happening there, especially in the last years, that you have economic growth, but they managed to decouple it from resource use and electricity use.
So their image is basically behind what they really do.
Yeah, I think if you make it more specific, because green economy is such a buzzword, if you look really at specific sectors, I think I was influenced by the images of Napoli and waste on the street. But if you look actually what's happening in the north and mid of Italy, they're one of the top performers in the recycling of urban waste, 70%. We are not there yet. Some regions, Contarina, Veneto, have 87%. That's really amazing. Bioeconomy, we always think about Italy, about food. It's important, one-fifth of the economy. But if you look at the land use for organic agriculture, it's the second one after Spain. So they're working there as well. But it's not all, everything is glorious in Italy in circular economy. There is room for improvement. I think the cities...
everywhere.
The cities could be a lot greener than they are today. So that touches upon topics like sustainable mobility, electric cars, charging infrastructure, and especially now after COVID-19, you see that cycling and cycle infrastructures become very, very popular. Other topics, maybe solid waste management in the south, and of course, water management is very important in Italy.
Yeah, I was about to ask you, what opportunities do you see for Dutch companies in the water technology sector?
Well, you're asking me, but especially tomorrow, you should look at the webinars on water management, and there will be also a presentation on, let's say, market opportunities in the water technology and the bioeconomy by the Consortio Ital Biotech. Don't miss it, and what I do is basically give you a little sneak preview. First, maybe explain the market a little bit.
Yeah, explain the market to me first a little bit, and to our viewers.
Italians use a lot of water, so more than 25% more than Europeans, more than 66% more than, let's say, global inhabitants. Largest part is for agriculture, 60% more or less. But then if you look at the water infrastructure, and when I think about Italy and water, I see aqueducts. In the times of the Romans, those guys were the masters of water, no?
Yeah, that's also my image, but that's a while ago, right?
So. But Exactly. Their infrastructure is old and maintenance has left a lot to be desired. So if you look at leakage, it's 37.6%, which is the highest in Europe. So that's a huge loss.
That's worrying.
That's indeed worrying. And then at the same time, we see the climate is changing. 2017, and I was there as well, there was an incredibly dry year, 80% less precipitation. But the last years, there's more rain, more mud floods. You've seen the images on the telegiornale. So things are changing. Regulatory point of view, it's patchwork. It's very fragmented. Every region has its own specific parameters, which makes it slightly more complex to do business. They have a soil issue in Italy. I think there's no country which loses so much soil as Italy. Yeah, they're the number one in soil loss. But it's not possible to reuse the soil, the sludge from water treatment on the soil.
Why not?
Well, it's regulations. It's very different. So you have to convince everybody that every parameter is right. So it's not always everywhere in the same way. So if you look then at opportunities, I think improvement of the infrastructure, of course, to, let's say, the catchment of water, but also
And are these the fields that you think that the Dutch businesses can really help?
I think there are a lot, but let's say it's water capture, prevention of loss, better use of water, reuse of water, water for agriculture, better water treatment. Some specific example that's always nice to talk.
Do you have an example that makes me really think in an image?
Okay, the island of Sicily. It's beautiful, but if you look at water treatment, I think they are a little bit lagging behind. It's underdeveloped, underutilized installations, uncompleted, outdated. So that's a clear solution. In general, the islands are suffering from drought a lot. So there is an option. The countries regions like Sardinia and Puglia really put a focus on reusing water. Of course, for Italy, water and agriculture is very important. Water and horticulture is very important. But the one maybe I like most as an opportunity for the Dutch is actually the water treatment and the reuse of nutrients also in and resources in industry.
Yeah. I'm not always talking. What do you mean by the reuse of nutrients?
Well, if you look at water, water is connected to everything. So water is an energy carrier, but there's also lots of substances in water. When you clean plants, there are elements in the water which you can retrieve and reuse in your production process. When you have water treatment, of course, there are stinks or sludge which are very valuable, which you can retrieve. And if you combine that with another, I think, huge opportunity is decentralized treatment plants. So not using mega scale, but micro scale, smaller communities, industry, and even for households, I think there are lots of options. So maybe for the Italian viewers, some examples. There's Bluecon, that is such a decentralized solution which we have. It's wastewater treatment, very quick installment, very affordable price, and the sludge can be reused again for agriculture. Then Hydraloop, I remember seeing it on the Dutch news. It actually reuses the household water up to 45%. So imagining topping up your pool or flushing the toilet with your shower
with the water
which has
that
been
you
cleaned.
Used before, yeah.
And, well, we were talking about textiles just before, and textiles in industry uses lots of water. And there are solutions like the NX filtration, which have, now I'm so going to say something technical, they have hollow fibers, nanofiltration membranes, and they manage to actually to reuse the water coming from the textile industry. And because it's very intensive, that makes sense. And one is maybe more daring to imagine. Can you imagine giving your toilet paper a second life?
Well, no.
that's
I don't know if I want to, honestly.
Well, maybe you should. There's Grupo CAP and Sciatec. They have in Italy, first in Italy, they have a demo-sized installation where they recapture the cellulose, the toilet paper, from the wastewater. And actually, in the Netherlands, this material is not a waste anymore. You can reuse it as in the pavement of a bicycle path. So
okay, so my toilet paper becomes a bicycle path.
So if you summarize it all about the opportunity, I think it's all about fit-for-purpose water. So the right quantity, in the right quality, in the right time for the right application. And it's not only about sustainability, it's also about value. So it makes very much business sense.
And how long do you think that this will take to get all these innovations coming through? Is COVID then an accelerator? How do you see that?
I think from water perspective, Italy is aware that things are changing. And I really like the Dutch approach, which is learning by doing. Yep. Learn fast, fail fast, don't wait till the world is perfect, the regulation is in place. I think the need is high, first movers have the biggest opportunities. And the Dutch are typically guys who can be very flexible and entrepreneurial in this field.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we are the kind of the doing, learning by doing kind of
right.
people.
Yeah.
This. And what message would you like to convey to Dutch companies in the water sector when they want to do business?
With regard to Italy, well, have faith, it's close to the Vatican. No, it's a really, it's a fantastic, it's a unique country. It's the eighth economy in the world, let's not forget that. Something will happen there. They have great and creative entrepreneurs and they will take action. They, something will happen and water is so essential for the economy of Italy, so it will be a top priority. It's an energy carrier, it contains nutrients, it's essential for food, so it will happen. But to echo a little bit what Geert-Jan Pastoor also said, Italy is famous for food, it's famous for culture, but it's really the people who make it interesting. It's so vibrant. It's like their family relations. There's never a dull moment.
Yeah.
There are alti and bassi, there's emotion, there's passion. But in the end, let's say their relations with lust, which are real. So invest in people, do find a partner. It's worth it. Italy will really be your favorite country.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. We will all look at the webinar tomorrow and then we will really know where the opportunities are.
Don't miss it. Italian companies, Dutch companies. It's about wastewater treatment. It's about the use of water in agriculture and a fantastic report by Ilaria Re. So go and have a look.
Thank you, Freek.
You're welcome.